Have you ever made an outstanding design but faced a hard time making a 3D model for it? Then this video is right for you. What's going on, fellas? I'm Geo and this is Geo Creations. You can find me on Instagram as Geo Jerwin. Let's jump right into the video. In this video, we're going to see how to make an impressive render like this only using Photoshop and nothing else. First, as usual, let's start with the sketch. Actually, I tried doing this in Rhino, but it didn't came out well. But I can't ditch my idea, so then I decided to make it in Photoshop. First, I've traced my sketch using Illustrator. You can also do this in Photoshop itself. After tracing your sketch, you can start giving your base texture. For giving a texture, you first need a texture. For the material I've used here, I've chosen the concrete texture from one of the texture packs of Upstairs. I'm linking that down in the description below. Check that out if you want, or you can just get one high resolution image from Google. Now let's style up the texture and make it as a single one. And now we can adjust its color by the HSL layer. To open that, click on the layer and press Ctrl plus U. Now to remove the original color, check the colorize box. Now we can change the hue with the respective color. Also, you can play with the saturation and highlights. To adjust the lighting, you can use Ctrl plus L. And here you can adjust the contrast and brightness of the material using these sliders. And before that, make sure if your layer is a small object so that you can edit your settings later on by double clicking over here. Okay, now the texture is ready. Now we need to select a single face using the pen tool. After that, make a selection and color it using the paint bucket tool. Now place your texture above it, and here you can see the original face has a bend. To make that bend, press Ctrl plus T to show up the control points and adjust it closer to the boundaries of our target face. Now right click and select warp. Now you can easily bend your texture. After that, with your texture layer selected and the face layer below, press Ctrl plus Alt plus G to create a clipping mask to the layer below. And now the texture will just be in an area of the layer below. Change the blend mode to multiply, and what it does is, it changes the lighting of the subject according to the layer below. If the underlying layer is lighter, the texture will also be lighter, and vice versa. This is the power of the blend mode multiply. Likewise, let's apply the texture for everything. We got a decent profile. Now let's search for a sight in accordance to our initial sketch. This cliff over here feels like a good choice. Let's cut down the unwanted parts. After some stretching and stamping, we got this. Now we need to mask out the unwanted parts. I made a composite of multiple images and I have adjusted the lighting and the color of each one of them. Now we kinda got a background to work with. Now let's give a depth to our texture. To do that, create a new layer over the texture layer and create a clipping mask by pressing Ctrl plus Alt plus G. Now take a soft brush. Make it bigger, make the flow to somewhere around 15 and start painting black on the areas where the shade comes and progress with lighter flow for lighter shades. And do the same with highlights with white color. I highly recommend to watch this video after watching this to know the process in detail. You can check the link in the description or just click on this I button. After giving basic highlights and shadows, we need to give other details like grooves and holes to make the composition interesting. Making grooves and holes is actually simple. You just need to play with the shades and shadows from the last step. Just select the portion you need the hole and press Ctrl plus J to make a copy. Reduce the brightness by adjusting the levels after that. Now draw a shadow on top of that. Wasn't that simple? Now let's see how to give lighting like this. First, make the light source and give it a bright color. Now double tap on the layer and check the outer glow box and select a bright color. It can be white or the same color as our light source. Now create another layer and select the areas where you need the light to be fallen. And with the soft brush tool, select the same color as the source and paint over it. Change the blend mode to screen. You can see that the light is falling even in the shadow area. To fix that, double click on the layer and in the underlying layer, move the shadows to the right. Press Alt to split the slider for a smoother transition. Now it's time for some nitty gritty details which makes the render more real. Add some scratches, damages and weathering details to make it more real. Let's add some water splashes in the foreground. Get a random wave image from Google, mask it, copy it, and adjust the lighting. Now it's time for the elements which makes it feel like wow. First, I'm adding a rain overlay. For that, I'm downloading a rain overlay image from Google. And let's change the blend mode to screen. Mask it out from the unwanted areas. Now let's add some fog, and now it's time for our most important step. Before that, make sure to leave a like on this video so that YouTube pushes this video for more people. Okay, back to the topic. Now press Ctrl plus Shift plus E to create a stamp visible layer. Make that into a smart object and press Ctrl Shift plus A to open Adobe Camera Raw. Now adjust the lighting and color here. To know more about these settings, check out this video right over here by clicking on this I button. Also, I've linked that down in the description. After adjusting the basic lighting, click on Done. Now copy the same layer and apply a preset. This one is my custom preset. Now after hitting Done, you need to adjust the levels to make the exposure and contrast right. You can also play with the curves a little bit. And also you can reduce the intensity of the preset by reducing the layer's opacity. Now it looks perfect. If you want the PSD file of this work to get a better understanding of the process, leave a DM on my Instagram. Because if I leave the link in the description, it expires as the file size is too large. Now share this video with a friend who has made a wonderful design but struggling to make a 3D model for it. Feel free to ask your questions below and don't forget to join our small community by subscribing to the channel. Catch you guys in the next video. See ya.